Were you silent or were you silenced? I just want to make it clear to everybody.
Royal fans are already counting down to Meghan and Harry's Oprah interview, and it's now being reported that they are going to address the tension with the royal family. Hey guys, welcome back to another Shared News from Home. We have got to talk about this major royal news, but before we get started, if you're new here, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss out on any future updates. As always, I'm your host, Vanna Zaring, and today I'm joined by the wonderful Mariah Davis. Mariah, I know you're a fellow Royals fan. This is very interesting news. Let's just dive right in. If you've been keeping up with all things Royals, you know that Meghan and Harry recently decided to permanently step down from their roles as senior members of the royal family, which has honestly made their highly anticipated Oprah interview even more exciting. They, of course, don't do sit-down interviews that often, and fans are hoping that this will be a time to get some answers to a lot of the questions we've had on our minds for quite some time. A source close to the couple told E! News that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will be, quote, speaking their truth during the highly anticipated special, which, by the way, airs on March 7th, so mark your calendars if you haven't already. The source continued saying, there is a lot of tension between them and the royal family. The interview is going to shine a light on what they have been through. Meghan and Harry are relieved they are away from it all. So if this source is actually close to the couple and we can take these words, you know, as the truth, this is pretty interesting because they have obviously been through a lot. So many rumors, so much pressure. They've had legal battles. It's going to be really interesting to hear, you know, an unfiltered version of their story.
My biggest concern was history repeating itself.
Yeah, it's nice after, I mean, for Harry, it's been his entire life of having to stay silent, not being able to just live freely. So many rules to live by. And Meghan came in and kind of changed the game for him. I think she was his saving grace, you know, an out to a life that maybe he never wanted to lead, a position that he never really wanted or asked for, which I totally get this from all of the many TV shows I've seen. And that's like how the character is portrayed. They never wanted the life of royalty, but I mean, obviously trade places with him in a heartbeat, but I do think it's great that they finally have an opportunity to speak freely, live their lives. We all want to know. Everyone has been dying to know the truths to the tabloids, to things that we've read in articles for all of these years. And we're finally going to hear what Harry and Meghan have to say about their experience. I don't think that they're going to just be throwing the entire royal family under the bus. I don't think that we can expect that, but it will still be nice to just hear what they actually have to say for like once.
Yeah, I totally agree. And you know, they're royalty. They have a really good friendship with Oprah, who I also consider royalty. So what's going to be even more interesting is this is going to be someone that they've probably had even more candid conversations, you know, than this with behind closed doors. So I think it's going to be a really comfortable setting. It's going to be handled in a way that, you know, what comes out of this is really what they want the world to know, which will be fascinating.
I don't know how they could expect that after all of this time, we would still just be silent if there is an active role that the firm is playing in perpetuating falsehoods about us.
According to The Insider, their sit-down is going to be, quote, very candid because they've officially been released from their royal duties. So the timing of this, to me, is clearly not a coincidence.
Agreed. Like I said, they finally have an opportunity to just speak freely without being restricted of everything they can say. So I think it's great that, especially with Oprah, I mean, someone that we all love, we all know and love, she's always the one to like dish out the best tea, but in a not like drama scandal type way. She has consistently throughout history been the platform for notable names to set the record straight and to tell their story. So the timing definitely makes sense. Now they finally have the freedom to just say what they want to say.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree with you more. The source did get into some of the topics they plan to address. So let's get into kind of what this interview might look like. The source said, quote, they're going to touch on a lot of how mental health came into play and how it affected them. As we know, Meghan and Harry have fiercely advocated for mental health awareness, you know, in the charity work that they're doing. So I have a feeling that this segment is probably going to be very powerful. We know it's a topic that's really important to them. We know that they've sort of touched on having struggles with mental health themselves, but they've never really been able to share candidly what that experience has looked like. And I think it can be really powerful to hear, you know, just such prominent figures opening up about their mental health journeys. The couple just announced they're expecting another child after Meghan suffered a miscarriage. And a press release announcing the interview stated that Meghan will talk about, quote, stepping into life as a royal, marriage, motherhood, philanthropic work, to how she is handling life under intense public pressure. So I think for me, the Meghan of it all, as interested as I am in Harry, her journey is something that I, like you said, who wouldn't want to be a duchess, a princess, right? It seems so glorious, so wonderful, but we've seen her go through a lot. And it makes me think of that moment on their tour when a reporter asked, are you okay? And that short exchange that they had back and forth, you know, really like broke the internet, right? Everyone was talking about how powerful it was because it was the first kind of candid glimpse into the fact that behind the scenes, she, you know, was struggling a little bit. So I can't wait to hear what this journey was like for her. So many people envied her in the beginning. And now I'm like, I don't know that I could have taken on a fifth of what you've gone through.
Exactly. I mean, as glamorous as it may seem to be in a royal position, like a fairy tale come true, it's not really so much like that. I think we've seen from the very beginning, Meghan really struggled being accepted by the royal family, being accepted by those who are in love with the royal family. As much as we all love to see a fairy tale, she just wasn't really accepted, and why we may never know, but I think it's great that finally she has an opportunity to really share what that experience was like without having to be so locked down or restricted on what she can say. She can finally just be open and honest. And because of their advocacy with mental health awareness, which I think is great, and I think the two of them have firsthand experience on what it's like to experience really struggles with your mental health. When you're in the public light like they were, and you're constantly taking ridicule, you're constantly being judged for every decision you make, it can really wear on you. So they finally have an opportunity to just be really open and transparent with people. And I think a lot of people are going to find them very relatable.
Yeah, I agree. I think, you know, we've seen little interviews here or there, you know, they've popped up on some Zoom calls this year, you know, surprising charities. And every time they speak, they seem really, really down to earth. I know I've listened to some of their podcasts and they're really great. So it'll be interesting to sort of see them step into this role, not as royals, but as themselves, what those personalities look like, what, you know, makes them laugh, what is important to them. Aside from their, you know, official royal duties, which obviously they took seriously, but that's a different world, right? Obviously, a huge source of interest is the rumored feud between the royal couples. I mean, this has been ongoing in the tabloids for years. Rumors continue to spread that Harry and William are not on good terms. A friend of Meghan and Harry's recently revealed that Harry was, quote, heartbroken over the estrangement from his family. And E! News's source admitted that it's, quote, still a very tense situation, adding that Harry and William are on two different paths. Now, of course, they're on two different paths. William is second in line to the throne, and Harry is, you know, delving into the world of California, signing deals with Netflix and Spotify, you know, creating a new life. So to say they're on two different paths is almost an understatement. I think the real question everyone wants answers to is how much tension is there, right? Like, what of these feud rumors, these drama rumors, is real? It's hard to navigate with so many tabloids and so many headlines ranging from everything is great to nobody is speaking, what's been true over the years. But any step they take to kind of address the tension within the family is going to be monumental.
Yes. And if we know Oprah for anything, is that she really asks not necessarily hard, uncomfortable questions, but questions that we all want to know the answers to. We see a lot in celebrity interviews. They just kind of tiptoe around what we really want to know. And, you know, to each their own, that's their personal business with what they feel comfortable sharing and what they don't feel comfortable sharing. But I don't think that they would sign up to have this interview with Oprah of all interviewers if they weren't going to really kind of uncover some of the popular rumors. So I think it's going to be really nice to hear from Harry or Meghan what their relationship with them really is like, and just kind of put to bed some of the rumors. That can only make things so much harder, I imagine. If you have a little bit of tension between you and your family, to have the entire world make their judgments and rumors about that, on how something happened and who had the falling out, who was in the wrong. So it's going to be nice to hear them clear up some of those rumors.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more. This is not the only major royal TV moment that is on its way. We have another one right around the corner. After Meghan and Harry announced their plan for this interview with Oprah, Queen Elizabeth sort of had a comeback announcement with a TV appearance of her own. Westminster Abbey posted news that a message from Her Majesty will air during a BBC One special entitled A Celebration for Commonwealth Day on the same day as Meghan and Harry's interview, which is, of course, March 7th. So a lot of people are calling this, you know, the Queen's sort of comeback to Meghan and Harry's interview, sort of an attempt to steal the spotlight. What do you make of this, Mariah?
I don't think the Queen of England ever needs to steal the spotlight. You know, she, I don't feel like that's something she feels challenged in. The timing is interesting, though, especially because the Queen so rarely is in front of the camera or makes any types of statements. So I'm excited to see, mainly because I would just like to hear her speak. I don't think I've ever heard the Queen of England speak. So the timing is interesting. I don't know if it was necessarily a petty, like, trying to overshadow them. Again, she's the Queen of England, y'all. She wakes up with the spotlight. She doesn't need to try and really work for one.
Yeah, I don't know that I totally agree with you. I don't know that this was like a petty chess move. I think it could be an attempt to, you know, add some more news to the cycle that day, right? She doesn't want everyone to be talking about one thing. She's given them a bunch of different options. It does seem like it's going to be a fairly formal appearance, but we'll have to wait and see. Maybe she's going to be doing her own version of a tell-all and take us all by surprise. You never know. Crazier things have happened. All right, you guys, on that note, we want to know your thoughts on everything going on in the world of the royals. Are you excited for Meghan and Harry's interview? Let us know down in the comments. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell, because we will keep you updated on all things royals. As always, I'm your host, Fiona Zaring. I was joined by the wonderful Mariah Davis. If you want to come say hi, our social handles are on the screen right now. Thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.